Today we're going to talk about 2.7, which is lectures on further problem solving, which essentially means we're doing some more word problems. You're going to have two types of word problems in this section. You're going to have money type problems, and you're going to have distance rate time problems. So please expect one of both on the actual test. Remember, help me solve this is good in my math lab, but you also need to make sure that you're being able to organize these on your own. On the test, if you guess and get it right, you're going to get points taken off because you didn't show your work. So on both of these, we're going to actually make charts up. The charts are optional, highly recommended, but the equation is mandatory. So I want you to go ahead and read the first problem. At any time, you need to pause and make sure you work through it on your own. Sometimes you're going to want to try to work on it before me, just like we would have done in class. I'll a lot of times try to remind you of that. When we're setting up a chart for money, we will always have what are our bills or coins on the left-hand side. So if it's, you know, a nickel, you'd put a nickel down, a dime, etc. And what is that worth? Okay. And we're going to have a column of the number of bills. They're usually going to give us a relationship for that piece. And then the value of the bills, which is where we multiply. Because if I told you you had 20 nickels, you would multiply 20 times 0.05 to figure out how much money you have. Same thing applies here. We're going to multiply across. So when we read this, it tells me we have six times as many. Our $50 bills X, we're going to call our number of $20 bills 6X. So the value would be 20 times 6X, which is going to, again, I'll write it down here for you so you understand what I'm doing, is 120X. My $50 bills would be 50 times X, which would give me 50X. And they tell me the total amount of money I have is 3,910. So my equation, if you don't want to do a chart, that's okay. But your equation that you need is you need the $20 bill values plus the $50 bill values equals the total. So for this problem, we're pulling from the chart 120X plus 50X equals 3,910. This equation needs to be on your paper. So now we're going to solve. So we add them together. We get 170X equals 3,910. And to solve this, we take 3,910 over 170. Now, right off the bat, you should actually know that these zeros cancel. And so, if you didn't have a calculator, but you should, we should be able to divide this out, you should get 23. So, why I find having a chart valuable is it's super easy to look back at the chart and see what you just found. We just found the number of $50 bills. So the number of $50 bills is 23, and the number of $20 bills, would be 6 times X. So 6 times 23 is 138. So they asked for you to find the denominations of both. These have been my answers. Please be careful when you're typing into my math lab that you're putting in the correct answer blank, the correct amount, meaning that you're looking at the denomination. Other things to be careful on. You can't get a decimal value for these answers for when talking about money. So if you did, you did something wrong. If they give you a negative when you solve, you did something wrong, because we're always going to be finding how many when we're talking about this. Now, I want to give you just a real quick side note. Sometimes they're going to give you a relationship like this, where they will tell you that you have a total of 25 bills. In this case, if they tell you that you have a total of 25 bills, this is where you got to be careful. You call one of them X, and a lot of y'all want to do X minus 25, but it should be 25 minus X, because if I add these two together, you want a total of 25, so the X's have to cancel. So if they ever give you a total number of bills or a total number of coins, you would call one of them X and one of them would be the total minus X. So I'm gonna shrink this down so you can see the whole problem. Again, pause this and read it. There will be two types of distance rate time problems that you're going to see in this section. One will be what we call the total distance problem, where you have one going one direction, the other going the other direction. So it is a total distance where we're going to be adding them together. And the second type will be what they call same distance. They're actually catching up to each other. So I'm going to make up a chart. I think that's really valuable, but it's not mandatory. So we have two cars. One is going northeast. One is going southwest. So if you read this, they gave me the rate. I don't care which section I'm in, I always list my rate, time, and distance. And notice I draw a double line. This is to tell myself that if I'm going left to right, I'm always multiplying. So they give me 65 miles per hour for my rate for my northeast and 41 miles per hour. And the units miles per hour tells you it's the rate. And I want to know how long it will take the two cars to go a total of 530 miles per hour, miles apart. So this is a total distance because they're going in opposite directions. And other keyword in here is same time. So I'm going to call that X. So for distance, we always multiply across. Because this is a total distance problem, we will take the distance that the northeast car drove plus the 41X, which is the southwest distance, and it should give me a total of 530. This is mandatory. The chart is not, but I highly recommend it. So we now add our like terms. We get 106X equals 530. Divide both sides by the 106X. And again, this is where I would use your calculator. We should get 5. What I like about the chart is I have no confusion on what I just solved for. This is the time. So I look back at what it asked for me to find. It actually asked for me how long does it take. So it actually asked me that for an answer. My answer here is 5 hours. Please get in the habit of using the chart. It really helps in the beginning, organizing, and in the end in answering the question. So going to number 3, again, pause it and read it. So I have my chart set up again. Two trains leaving Orlando, same time, that's an important word. One is traveling north and one is traveling south. So the key here is the one traveling south is the speed is 15 miles per hour faster than the north. So the north's rate is X. South would be 15 miles per hour faster. So we add 15 to the rate. 2 hours. So they left at the same time after 2 hours. So in this case, the 2 is my time. They're always going to give you one column completely. And so now we multiply across to get my distance. That's why, again, I draw the double line. And this is a total distance, so we are going to add distance 1 plus distance 2 equals the total. So we have 2x plus 2 times x plus 15 equals 230. I'm going to get rid of my parentheses by distributing. Collect my like terms, so I get 4x plus 30 equals 230. Subtract 30 from both sides, that gives me 200. Divide both sides by 4, and that gives me 50. Super easy to see what I just solved for. 50 is my rate for my north car, and we look back at what it wanted us to find. Sorry, this is a train. So we want to find the speed for each train. So the north is going 50 miles per hour. The south is 50 plus 15, so it's 65 miles per hour. That is my answer for this problem. Go ahead and read number 4 for me. Again, pause. Come back when you have it set up and read. So on this one, we have a bus in a car. So I'm going to label that. And the bus is traveling at 60 miles per hour, so they gave me the rate. The car is traveling at 40 miles per hour, and the car had a 1.5 hour head start. So we actually want to find out how long the bus is traveling. So if we can make that a variable, we want to. So the bus travels X amount of time. The car was on the road an hour and a half longer, which means we will add it to that time. Stop and think about it. If you're not sure, plug in a number and say to yourself, what would you have done? So we now multiply across. So I get 60x and the 40 times x plus 1.5. And this is a same distance problem because we have one trying to catch up to the other. So my equation, which needs to be on your paper, if you chose not to do the chart, that's okay, but this needs to be there. So we're going to get rid of the parentheses. Multiply out, it gives me 40x plus, and then if you do 40 times 1.5, you will get 60. I'm going to subtract 40 from both sides. 60 minus 40 gives me 20x. And I'm going to divide both sides by 20, which gives me 3. Again, stop. What did we just solve for? That's why I like the chart. X is equal to the time that the bus is on the road. So the bus is on a road for 3 hours. Now, another question I could have asked on this problem is I could have actually said, how far did they go until it caught up? So in that case, if I wanted a distance, the distance above is equal to 60x, so 60 times 3 would be 180 miles. This is my answer for what it asked, but I could ask a different question. So please, always when you're done with the word problem, ask yourself what actually was your variable you solved for. Is that what I wanted as my answer? That will save a lot of you some careless mistake points on the test.